Malaysia Open 2023. And after a scintillating display from Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan just now in 29 minutes, 2-0 winners over their compatriots, we have another men's doubles match ready. And Wei Kang and Wang Chung against another Indonesian pair, the second seeds, Marcus Gideon, Kevin Sukamuljo. And this is what the draw looks like for them. In fact, this is what the draw looks like for the men's doubles. And Kiredi and Shetty currently leading that Fikri Maulana match. Aaron Chow and Song taking on Liu Nu. And of course, we've got Liang and Gideon. Sukamuljo, they will play the winner of the Rasmussen match. And here they are. How it looks. They, I'm sure, would have seen Wang and Liang just now the destruction. The Danis against their compatriots. Here's Marcus Canaldi Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukamuljo. Once second in the world, now down to 23rd. Yes, Liang Wei Kang and Wang Chang, world number 17s. And they, of course, have had a meteoric rise up from 179. This should be on paper a very solid win for the Indonesians again, but really, Liang and Wang have put in some great performances. And there's the head-to-head, as you can see, they lead 1-0. Indonesia Masters 22. Straight games as well.
Red, red is the ball. It's black, your choice. Side. You are going to serve or receive? Who's going to serve? You? Receive?
So, the last match on court two today, after the sad withdrawal of Darren Liu, succumbing to that calf injury that was really troubling him during his first round match. And therefore, of course, all of us were not treated to his round of 16 match against Victor Axelsen, the reigning world and Olympic champion. So Victor, of course, with a walkover through to the quarterfinals, where he will play Kei Nishimoto. As of that, that was going to be, of course, match number six. We've got here 22 years old, Liang Wei Kang, Guangdong, China, ranked 17th right now, peak of their ranking. As I said, they really have climbed up from 179. Very short amount of time. 21-year-old Wang Chang, Zhejiang in China, 17. Liang have been together on this roller coaster ride. The winner of this match will face, as we saw earlier, Fernando Martin or Astrup Rasmussen. That was their last win. Took out the home pair of Go and Izzuddin. 16-21, 21-11, 21-17 in 54 minutes. And as for Marcus Fernaldi Gideon, more age, definitely pushing a little bit more now, 31 years old. He's 23. Rank is far cry from when they were absolutely unstoppable at number one. And of course, things do change. And generations change as well. 27-year-old Kevin Sanjaya Sukamuljo. Brand new Wang in Indonesia. And that's the pair that they beat to get here in straight games. 33 minutes, as you can see, they were absolutely devastating. Liang Wei Chong and Ti Hai Wen had no chance. Well, service judge eyes out Rusli. Umpire in place as well.
And about ready to get underway here. Actually, for Gideon and Sukamuljo, well, this is a return to the Malaysia Open. They actually pulled out of last year's. Still recovering from the surgery. It moved some bone growths in his right and left ankles. That's why, of course, their world ranking took a dip. They actually withdrew from three tournaments because of that in the early part of
Ladies
last year.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Kevin Sanjay Sukamuljo and Marcus Ferdinand return Indonesia. And on my left, Liang Beijing, Wang Chang, China.
It's Gideon that still had that surgery.
Wang Chang, served to Kevin Sanjay Sukamuljo.
As I said, these are the trials and tribulations about being a tall player. And they've still got the raw talent, the skill. He's shooting for a quarterfinal berth here.
So it's over. Two
points to the Indonesians.
Out. So it's over. One, two.
Rapturous applause, I said, Baron Chow and Sohu Yik in court next to them.
So it's over. 3-1.
Currently on a comeback run of sorts by the looks of it.
4-1.
Had a little glance at the scores. Lost the first game to Liu Liu. Another three up in a second. Meanwhile here, 4-1 up for Gideon and Sukamuljo. Oh, that lift a bit long,
so
playing from the driftier side of the court.
4. Service ball called too high. Service over, 5-2. Service over, 3-5.
Early chance here for Liang and Wang to get back on parity with points. 3-5 down on serve. Late reply from Gideon. Well, that's been challenged, though I do think that's wishful thinking. That looked very out.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 4-5 play.
Close match so far.
Ball. Service over. 6-4.
Very quick points.
7-4.
11 points ditched out. 3 minutes on court.
Out.
Such a stark difference from that 92-minute thriller between Onai Narioka and Ng Si Yong earlier. That wide.
6-7.
A couple of errors from Sukamuljo. And Liang and Wang back in it. It's very much age versus experience as well. It's good power for Gideon.
So it's over 8-6. It's over 7-8. Over 9-0.
Credit to the Chinese pair for keeping up here. They've matched everything that's been thrown at them so far. And that's a great cross court.
So it's over 10.
To take the lead at 10-9.
Service over 10-0.
Sukamuljo still coming up with a couple of misreads in terms of those drop shots. So it hasn't all been Liang and Wang winning off outright winners at all. There's definitely some points coming off the racket of Sukamuljo. So we want to pull that in. See that happen now.
Court two, 20 seconds. Court two, 20 seconds.
The Indonesian pair not used to this, having to catch up points. Whoa! Some good reflexes from the Chinese pair. So, while they are trading barbs and trading points, still no one with a clear outright chance at the game, you'd have to say. If we went on in this pattern, you'd think there's just going to be extra points until somebody wins.
So it's over.
But I really do have faith in Gideon and Sukamuljo to pull themselves together when they need to. It was quite a serious surgery that Gideon had in those bone spurs.
Service over, 13 all.
But yeah, Wang notched up some great results over the last year. Quarterfinalists at the Australian Open, Hilo Open, French Open, won the Japan Open. And third in the Malaysian Masters, second in the Indonesian Masters.
13.
And no slouches at all, these 21 and 22-year-old pair. That's being challenged. I'm sure. Yes, it is. To be honest, did look like it was edging on the outside of the line.
Challenge unsuccessful.
That's how close it was.
One challenge remaining. Service over. 14 all play.
To get that from deep.
So it's over. 15-14.
So this first game really hanging in the balance, with both pairs playing well enough. That's Sukamuljo again. This time, of course, it was a string.
16.
But he hasn't been 14. His usual deft self around the net. It's been the source of a lot of points for Liang and Wang. He's going to know that as well.
So it's over. 15, 16.
That's great rotation from the Chinese pair. That's long.
So it's over.
So 17-15. Looking good for the first game. Really harrowing it there. The pressure was just too much. This young pair is literally taking up everything. And Gideon Sukamuljo can throw at them right now. Oh, just that one so shot at the end.
16, 18. So it's over.
19-16 lead here in the first game. And it should be good enough. Take it based on what we've seen. Still a little bit of recovery work for Gideon and Sukamuljo in terms of last year's very injury plagued year.
So it's over.
And now it looks like this young pair 19. Might have the edge on them.
Quick one, quick.
Yeah, definitely some movement problems on the Indonesian side. And it's game point to Liang and Wang, who are looking strong here. They know exactly what they should be doing. It's great recovery there from Wang.
So it's over. 18-20. Nothing is there. Liang, ready to receive. Nothing is there.
Game point. Deep serve. Oh, oh, Wang did very well. That's extra points. That was a smart move from Gideon Sukamuljo to use the flick serve. Well, that's more like the Kevin Sanjaya Sukamuljo that we know. As he takes it to 22-20. And that is the first game. Now, I wonder what they're going to do for the second game, seeing as how they know the quality of their opponents. I'm going to try and switch it up. Looking a little bit disappointed, I suppose, at game point. It's almost course for it too. Stadium currently erupting, as you can hear, I'm sure. An explanation for that is an absolutely thrilling match between Liu and U versus Chad. So the home crowd getting really behind the home pair. And I'm sure that's going to be an extra bit of atmosphere for these pairs to deal with. The adjacent court.
Court 2, 20 seconds. Court 2, 20 seconds.
So, game 2. And the youngsters, Liang, Wei Kang, Wang Chun, have to step up, try and take this to three games.
Second game. Low ball.
We saw in our match just before this that age did lose to experience in the end. Well, here, experience is one game up already.
Again.
Just missing out on those net shots.
So it's over. One-all. So it's over. 2-1.
Oh, 2-1. Looking a little bit tighter in the second game, Gideon and Sukamuljo, so far anyway. 3 points in, but like they've warmed up a little. Still, that's a great play from Liang and Wang. Deserving of a 3-1 lead.
What?
Really just keeping the pressure on. Good steep angle.
4-1
leaders in a second.
Five-one.
Really opened up in this second game.
So it's over. 2-5.
Gideon to serve. Just see that little bits of movement. And the Indonesian pair that still need a bit of renovation. That's great pressure again from Andy Wang. They've just realized that tempo is what it's all about here. Really up the pace in this second game. Nice little cross court, didn't quite work out. Good idea though.
Seven.
Seem to be coming back into this.
interception. Also a great return.
8-4.
Well, they were 6-2 down. It's 8-5 now. And in the same way that they just managed to sneak with that first game, they were actually game point down. They're using that experience of knowing how to win and clawing back this deficit. Seems like Liang and Wang picked up their tempo and pace. And that was immediately matched. Is that another string that's gone for Kevin Sukamuljo? I think it is.
9-6.
That's two rackets in 25 minutes. There's definitely something going wrong with his stroke there. But still, be happy the fact he's just 3 points back.
Ten six.
So
it's over. 7-10.
Take that. 10-7. See this turn around.
So it's over. 11-7 in the.
So the 11-point break, Wang and Wang still ahead, but not quite as confident as they were at the beginning of this second game when they really came out of the blocks blazing with a lot of pace and a lot of speed. And they raced to a 6-2 lead. You have to take into account the massive experience of Gideon and Sukamuljo. They're not that much older in terms of the age difference. Certainly not as big as Hassan Sietimwa versus Usuma Wadana and Ramitan, which was 12 years. And, well, 12 and 15 years, basically 27 years between that young pair and the old pair. And the old pair came out, won in straight games. Here, it's about 9 years and 6 years. So, still decent enough, but
11,
certainly
seven,
needs a lot of
play.
Coaxing, say a lot of work. That's just straight pressure.
12.
Wang and Wang.
7.
And I did think that this was actually the last match out on court, but it isn't. Armando Martin Astrup Rasmussen.
13.
She's kicking off.
7.
And that's going to be the winners of that match. Going to face the winners of this match in the quarterfinal. Again, Chinese pair just ready for whatever's being thrown at them. What a great rally. Snatch that in.
8-13.
It's the longest rally of the match, 50 shots.
Marcus Vernon Gilgen challenges all in. Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 14-8. Play.
14-8. Long.
Wang Chang challenges call out.
Oh, it looked very long from where I am. And I was right.
Challenge unsuccessful.
Very long. So challenge wasted in a sense.
One challenge remaining.
Nice smile.
Service over. 9-15. Play.
Hi.
10-15.
Well, they found their niche, Liang and Wang, as to how they can get some good points off this pair that they're facing. Whether it's a combination of forcing the mistake like that, or actually putting the pressure and upping the tempo of the points and rallies. Scoreline.
Nine, ten.
Gideon and Sukamuljo were just maybe a bit lucky in that first game. It could have been game over right now, or match over.
11-90.
Well, that's in.
12.
Still a clawback if they want to do 90. This in straight games. Very tough, highly unlikely. That should be
so it's over.
Game point.
20 game point.
Tied up at one apiece. Sure. That's great recovery there from Wang and Liang, and that's gone wide. So yes, 21-12. And we have
second game won by Liang
yet again.
And Wang Chang.
A third and deciding game.
One game all.
just looking through it, it's basically the Asan Setia one, Kusumawada Wadana Rambutan game. It was the only game that didn't go to three today. It's been a busy day on court two. Jinwei and Seyong. That was straight games. Stoeva and Stoeva versus Jolly and Pulena. That was three. And Lucin. Jin Yao. That was three. Anthony Ginting against Anders Andersen went to three. Tom Gakel and partner against Wu Fang Ron. Mixed doubles went to three. Also, Siyong and Kodai Nairo also went to three. Now, this match nine. The real question, I guess, is not whether it was going to go to three, but who's going to win it. From what we've seen, I have to say, I think it's going to be Wang and Liang. They seem to have the more confident and reliable pattern of point scoring. Gideon Sukamuljo, for all their talents and experience, have been snatching at points. Haven't really found a way through
two,
to stop this young
seconds,
pair.
Court two, 20 seconds. Final game, love all, play.
Well, they're giving it a go.
So it's 4-1, one, love.
That's for certain as they take the first point in the third game. Gone long as well now. I don't know whether this is in Liang and Wang's playbook to just stop doing what they were doing in the second game. They looked like they really had the hunger to get through that game. Now, a little bit lax and they're leaving a lot of opportunities. And you just can't do this against a pair like Gideon and Sukamuljo. It's as simple as that. Whether coming back from injury, recovering, or even just under the weather, this pair will destroy you if you give them easy points.
Whoa!
That's a good shot into the corner.
One, four.
Shot. So good to see them back to doing what they were doing in the second game, because those first 4 points unrecognizable.
So it's over 5-2.
kph for that winner's speed. Wow. Great from both pairs.
3-5.
quick though.
Chang, quick though. Thank you. Players back on court.
Scored from Sukamuljo and 6-3 up. Targeted the body.
Thank you.
Gideon
seven.
Finding that part of his form again. Too much power on that return. And it's been good to see Gideon Sukamuljo just raising their tempo as well, and they're just possibly thinking to themselves that if they're getting caught out by the pace of the points, then we'll show them exactly how fast we can play as well. Seems to be working.
Eight. Wang Chang challenges call out.
Challenge from Liang and Wang. Oh, that's well in.
Correction in. Six, eight, play. Seven, eight. Oh, my.
That was nicely eight. Pounced on by Wang.
Oh.
That has brought them level.
Nine, eight.
Well, this has been a little mini comeback of sorts.
Nine, all.
points are coming thick and fast now.
Nine.
Evenly balanced. I really am wondering as to who is going to be there when it gets to the business end of this deciding game.
Out.
So it's over. 10 all.
10
all. So nothing between them as they approach the final mid-game interval. Oh, that looked like it might be going wide, but
11-10.
Gideon's shot definitely went wide. Oh, it wasn't, it was in. So good try from him. Try and get that back. That was brilliant stuff from Liang. 11-10. They have a minute to think about now what they're going to do for the second half of the game. And at the end of this next 10 points, there's a spot in the quarterfinals. Currently, Astrup and Rasmussen leading Carlando Martin, by the way, on court four. 17-11, a lot can change.
Players back on court.
Body language of Marcus Kidd is not looking like he's too happy with himself.
Quickly.
Maybe they didn't expect to go to three. Maybe they've still feeling a little bit from that
11-10.
Injury recovery.
Play.
Play.
So it's over.
They're just not giving up, these two. Wonderful idea from Wang and Liang. They may be challenging it, but it did look long. Not for a second it could have been in. Oh, look at that.
Challenge.
It's way out. So, advantage to Gideon and Sukamuljo.
12-11, play.
Each other strike for stride here.
Oh.
Still needs a lot of work, and just look at the amount of space on the other side of the court.
Oh. 50. Service over. 14-50. Thank you. Liang.
They've tied each other up at every point. Really is just being played one point at a time for both of them. No clear strategy from either side. Well, I guess that is one way of laying it out. Marcus Gideon is quite happy 50. To just try and win every point as it goes. But as you can see, consistency from either side is really lacking. 1 minute, you get the winners. The next minute, it's the mistake. Gideon and Sukamuljo, they're at least asking the questions. Guy and Wang seem to be back in their passive mode again.
17-60.
Still not out of the woods yet, the way the points have been dropping.
So it's over. 17-all.
Service return. Liang and Wang now have the upper hand in terms of the advantage. Can they make it a 2-point lead?
Play.
Yeah. And the short answer to that is no.
So it's over. 18-0.
Of course, a moment to celebrate if you're getting closer to the end of the match and the end of the game. But really, if they can't just break forward now, make it 2018.
Oh!
that's another one. So back and forth it goes. Extra points looming.
Marcus, ready to receive.
They've moved step by step closer to the end of this match. And the first match point is here. But really, based on the way it's been going, you'd expect Gideon and Sukamuljo to pull themselves together again and tie this one up. Or can Liang and Wang end this here? From Gideon and Sukamuljo, and they are out. And the youngsters have come through in a marathon match. Okay. 21-19. It was always going to be either a winner or a mistake that decides this match. And in this case, it was Kevin Sukamuljo who's been vulnerable at the net, remember. And that costly mistake has sent them out of the Malaysia Open 2023. And Wang and Liang move on to the quarterfinals. And there's confirmation of that score. 2022, 21-12, 21-19. So happy smiles from the Chinese pair. And these are the results from day three here, round of 16. An Se-young with a two-game win over Go Jin-wei. The Stoeva sisters got past Jolene Pulela. Tai Tsu-ying in the women's singles beat Han Yu by two games. And then Ong En-tio, the Malaysian pair, took out Liu Qingyao and Yang Po-han in 85 minutes. That was followed by Anthony Sinisuka-Ginting winning two games to one over Anders Antonsen in 72 minutes. And then, of course, Tom Gikel, Delphine Delroux came through to the quarterfinals, taking out Hu Pangwon and Teo Meizing. The walkover for Victor Axelsen, as Darren Liu had to retire with his calf injury. Then the marathon match of the day, 92 minutes, a 2-1 win for Kodai Naraoka, coming back from one game down. That was followed by the all-Indonesian affair. Muhammad Hassan Hendra Setiawan coming through effortlessly in 29 minutes. Against Kusum Wadana and Rambitan. And finally, we just watched the youngsters Liang and Wang beat Gideon and Sukamuljo 2-1 in 56 minutes. So don't forget, tomorrow is quarterfinals day and matches are going to be starting at 9 a.m. But from me right now, it's goodbye and I will see you tomorrow.